Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this episode, we are going to talk about auth states, how to log in and sign out, well, basically automatically, and how we can handle all of that. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, in the previous episode, we have set up a lot of code and we left off in the view will appear method inside our root view controller, where we have added our should open mail app function. Basically, this opens up the mail app so the user can tap on that link that we have just sent him or her. Now, if you recall, let me just show my this device here. Let's build and run this. We had quite an ugly interface here because we don't have any text on the button nor the navigation title. So we are going to fix this today. And in the next episode, we are going to finally wrap it up. I know I promised you all of the wrap up for today's episode, but hey, we will have another tutorial tomorrow. So what we are going to do today is check for our auth state did change listener handle. Okay, first of all, we need to go all the way up here and declare our auth state did change listener handle. That's a mouthful. Okay, so var, let me just copy and this because it's quite hard to add that in here, and auth state did change listener handle, and I will make this an optional. Okay, that is first things first, and maybe I don't need to add, just declare it like so. Great. Now, in the view will appear, we want to listen for changes. So auth state did change listener handle dot, or rather let's add a value here, auth dot auth dot add state did change listener. So the listener is our auth and our user. So that is what we basically get back. Now, first of all, we want to check if we do have our auth or if we do have our user, because those are optional. Or rather, yet just check the user because we don't really care about the auth. So if let user equals nil or else, and if the user is nil, that means basically that we are not signed in. So if let user equals nil, then this means we are not signed in because we don't have a valid user. Now let's go further, and if let user equals user and let email equals user.email, then we do have a signed in user. Let me just fix this so we don't need let here. If the user is nil. So let's print out here. And what do we want to do? Well, first of all, we want to set our service auth state to be signed out. So let's do that. So service dot auth state equals dot sign out. Okay, and let's do the same in our user. So F here, let's print out and let's set our service auth state equals signed in. Again, this takes care of the UI logic. If we did set the state to be signed in, then we present something, and signed out, we present something else. Now, next up, we want to maybe set the navigation controller's title, sorry about that. So title to be, let's say, profile, because we are signed out, we don't really know the name of our user, or rather the email. And let's add in here a self, because we are in a closure. Let's do the same for our logged in user, self dot navigation controller dot title. And this time we are going to add in our email. Okay, we will present our email. Now, one last thing we need to do is handle the title of our button. So let's do that first when the user is nil. So self dot, and I believe it's sign in. Yeah, that is it. Sign in, sign out button dot, and set title. And the title should be sign in, because we are signed out, we should be signing in. Okay, and for the state of normal. And the same basically goes to our sign in, sign out button when we are logged in. But this time we are going to set the title to sign out. Okay, and for the control state of normal. Okay, let's build and run and see how this looks like. And of course, because we are signed in, then we need to have, when we are signed out, we need to have a sign in button here. And I don't know why this profile does not show up. I will need to take care of that later on. Finally, we are going to implement one last thing in this tutorial video, and that is to, sign out. But before we do that, I just remember that we need to remove the listener when the view will disappear, and that is pretty simple. Just grab the old did change state listener handler and just remove it. So let's add that in here. And because this is an optional, let's guard let unwrap it. So guard let equals that, else let's just return. Okay, and just type in auth.auth and remove state did change listener and just paste that in there. Okay, that is how we remove that listener. Now let's go all the way down and let's implement our sign out. First of all, let's create a detail text. So detail text. And that is signing out. And that is because the way this HUD is presented and handled. So let's present our HUD here. So handle HUD with info. So this will be our HUD. And our HUD info will be of type. And let's say show, because we are just going to show it, and we say working, and the detail text will be detail text. Okay, next up we want to grab our auth. So let auth equals auth, not auth. There we go. And now we want to sign out, but for that we need to add that in a do try catch statement. So let's add that in there. Now we want to try auth.sign out. Okay, and if we do get an error, then we want to handle that. Okay, let's print out the error for now. Okay, and that took care of all the errors and warnings in Xcode. But before we leave this video as it is, let's handle our HUD. So if we did sign out, we want to set our hard handle. And let's see here, hard, and our hard info will be of type error, or rather at success here. Sorry about that, success, and let's type in here success, detail text, successfully signed out. Okay, and for the error, we want to show a HUD with an error, a localized description. So there we go, HUD, HUD info. The type will be dot error, text error. And the string will be, for the details, localized description. Okay, I believe that is it. So let's build and run and try this out. Well, basically we cannot sign out, but if we tap on sign in, we can send the magic link. There we go. We will test this out. Let me just show you my QuickTime player. There we go. If we will test this out later on in the next episode. For now, let's just know that user is nil, and we will get the whole roundup in the next episode. Hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of the next and last video, where we will finally handle the incoming link from our email. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.